By the end of this video, you're gonna know exactly what you need to post to go viral on TikTok in April of 2021. I don't care if you have zero followers right now, a million followers right now, 10 million followers right now, whether or not you've gone viral before, you have not gone viral before, by the end of this video, you're gonna know exactly what TikTok wants for you to go viral. In fact, if you stick around for the end of this video, I'm gonna share with you two posts that I think are almost guaranteed to go viral on TikTok if you execute on them the right way. For those of you that don't know how the TikTok For You page works, it's incredibly simple. You need to do two factors right. You need to get a lot of watch time on your videos, they need to be the right length, and you need to make sure that you're posting content that TikTok thinks they have an audience for. Just simply put, if TikTok thinks they have an audience for your content, you're actually gonna get way more views than any other piece of content, and this can be the difference between you getting 1,000 views, 10,000 views, 100,000 views, or going viral and getting over 1 million views. And the reason that TikTok algorithm is so powerful, because it's not like YouTube, it's not like Facebook, it's not like Instagram, it's not like Twitter, you know exactly what you need to be posting on TikTok in order to go viral. They give you the analytics right after you post, and you can actually see whether or not you're post is going to go viral based on your analytics. And I'll be sharing with you a little bit more about that in just a second. Before I get into that, for those of you that don't know who I am, my name is Robert Benjamin. I'm the CEO of Helping You Grow on TikTok. I just made a video about the algorithm. I have videos about the best time to post, best hashtags used, and so many other videos. So please make sure you smash that subscribe button. You never want to miss another one of my episodes. In addition to that, please shoot me a text right here. I answer almost every single text message I get. And if you have a question about anything throughout this video, leave a comment below. I answer every single comment that I get on my YouTube videos. I quit my job working for Gary Vee almost 2 years ago now to help you grow on TikTok through this YouTube channel, and that is the only thing I want to do. I want to help you grow, so please let me help you grow. Ask me questions, shoot me a text message, and make sure you watch this video till the end, because I'm telling you, you won't regret it. So when it comes to creating content that TikTok thinks they have an audience for, you could essentially do that in three different ways. First, you could duet or stitch a viral video, which I strongly suggest you do. Secondly, you can recreate a broad trend on TikTok, and then third, you can recreate a niche specific trend on TikTok. Now, I get the question all the time in the comments, in my DMs, in my text messages, is Rob, what does all of that mean? So when it comes to duetting and stitching a viral TikTok video, basically what you're gonna wanna do, you're gonna wanna go to the top creators that you see on TikTok, see what they're duetting, see what they're stitching. It could be in your niche or just broadly on TikTok. Start duetting those videos, start stitching those videos, start hopping on those trends. No, this is not copying their content. This is not copying them. This is hopping on a trend. Since that video has already gone viral on TikTok and other videos doing that have gone viral on TikTok, TikTok thinks they have an audience for that content. So by you doing it and executing on it well, adding a hook in, incentivizing engagement, and doing so many other things that we're gonna chat about in just a little bit, then you have the chance to go viral, and that is one of the number one ways for your content to go viral. In addition to just finding videos that other creators are doing, if you scroll the For You page, find other duets, find other stitches, do those by duetting the original video, stitching the original video, and boom, it's gonna increase the odds of you going viral. Secondly, you need to be hopping on those niche specific trends. What does this mean? This means if you're posting about cats, or you're posting about dogs, or you're posting about Star Wars, or you're posting about Roblox or Minecraft, go into the biggest hashtags for whatever you're posting about, find the top creators under there, find the top videos under there. Again, duet those videos, stitch those videos, recreate those videos. You guys will notice a trend there. They're doing the same videos over and over again. They're doing the same type of content over and over again. That's the content that works in your niche. That's how you can make TikTok think that they have an audience for the content you're putting out. Using those same sounds, making those same types of videos, making sure that your text on the screen looks like what their text on the screen looks like, that the lighting looks like what their lighting looks like, and that you're talking about the topic that they're talking about. Because again, TikTok takes all of these things into consideration. The For You page takes the sound that you're using into consideration, the hashtag, the description, the length of the video, and so much more. So please, guys, don't think that it's as simple as just recreating a video. You need to make sure that you're paying attention to all those little details as well. And now, and finally, the broad trends on TikTok. How can you find the broad trends on TikTok? Literally just scroll the For You page, go on the Discover page, you'll see what is trending. For example, if I pull up TikTok right now,
1 hour later,
there are several trending sounds. For example, She Make It Clap by Soulja Boy. And if I go in here, you could see the same type of video over and over again. If you scroll and look at these videos, that means that those types of videos are trending under the sound. Those are the types of videos that you should be creating. In addition to that, I'll look at another one. Guitar Talk is trending right now. So if you post a video with a guitar, just like all these people are doing, using the same sound, using the same text on the screen, guess what? That is a broad trend going on TikTok right now. It's gonna trend for the next 24 to 48 hours, and you need to be hopping on that because it's gonna significantly increase the odds of you going viral. Now, I always get this question when I talk about the broad trends. Rob, do I have to do all of them? How many of them should I do? Every single post you post on TikTok should be trending. It should be trending broadly on TikTok in your niche, or it should be a stitch or duet of a viral video. That being said though, the broad trends, I know you might not be able to play guitar. That's fine. Don't do the guitar one then. Do the Brisero one. You could do that one. Or there's an Eco Hacks one. You could do that one also. There are several different trends, so do not want to hear the excuse that you can't participate in all of them. Now, of course, you shouldn't be able to participate in all of them, but 50%, 40%, 40%, 30% of them, you should be able to do that, which will equate to about 1 to 2 posts a day being from the Discover page. You guys need to make sure you're taking advantage of that. In addition, if you've had a post go viral on your account, you guys need to repost that post. You should be reposting that post every 72 hours using a different description, different hashtags, adding an incentivation for engagement on there, and do not delete the original video. When I talk about incentivizing engagement, I'm talking about giving people a reason to click the plus sign in the last 3 seconds of your video. The reason you want to do that is because you've already gotten good watch time. Boom, they follow you by clicking that plus sign. That's what the plus sign does. It's a much easier way, much less intrusive way for you to ask somebody to follow you as opposed to just saying, follow me. It's easier. And a lot more people do it. There's a much higher call to action, actually completion rate when you do that. So please make sure you do it that way. But nevertheless, what that signals to TikTok, when somebody watches the entire video, first, amazing watch time. Secondly, you know that there's an audience for the content because you're already doing what I just said 30 seconds ago. And then somebody follows you, boom. That is the best thing that you could show the TikTok algorithm. If they see that they have an audience for your content, they're watching the video all the way through, and then they follow you, guess what? You are going to go viral. And remember, when you repost a video, don't repost a video more than 4 or 5 times. It should get more views the next time you repost it. Do not repost videos that have flopped. I strongly advise you not to do this. Why? It's going to be a waste of a post. Try to do a different trend. Try to do a different stitch. Try to do a different duet. Do not repost videos that have flopped. Only repost videos that did really well or videos that went viral. In addition to that, like I said, do not private, do not delete the original video. Do not private or delete videos in general. So many people are privating videos on TikTok, deleting videos on TikTok, and it's destroying the amount of reach that you're getting. It can actually get you shadow banned. The reason being, if TikTok has their stuff, has your posts up there, and they're pushing it out, and then you take it away, why are they gonna push out your content in the future? They don't know if you're gonna take it down, if you're gonna private it, if you're gonna delete it, if you're gonna do something with it. So they're not going to put it in the algorithm on the For You page and get it pushed out to people. Please guys, do not do this. I see so many creators do this. It's a huge mistake. Do not delete your videos. Do not private your videos. The only reason you should delete or private a video is if a video gets a community guidelines violation and you lose the appeal. Do not delete it. Do not private it until you lose the appeal, or if there's a copyright claim against the video, then you can delete them, then you can private them. But again, guys, do not be doing this, please. Now I want to answer one of the biggest objections that I get on videos like this. It's, Rob, I don't want to make content like everybody else is making. Well, then guess what? You're not going to get big on this app. David Dobrik, of course, he's being canceled right now, but he was able to blow up on TikTok and gain more followers on TikTok in a shorter period of time than he has on any other social media platform. How? By hopping on the trends. He did not make original content. He didn't even make new content on the platform. All he did was hop on the trends. The biggest creators on the app are doing the same exact thing. I've seen this take people with no following to 100,000 followers, to 1 million followers, to 5 million followers overnight. I'm telling you guys, please, it is not copying anything. It is simply hopping on the trends and modeling your content after success. And that is how you're successful in this world. And it is also how you're gonna be successful on TikTok. Now, I've mentioned it a couple times in this video, your watch time. When it comes to your watch time, the watch time that you need to get if you wanna get on the For You page, if you wanna go viral, if you wanna get really pushed out in the TikTok algorithm, for videos less than 15 seconds long, it's gotta be over 100% watch time. For videos 16, 30 seconds long, you gotta aim for 75%. And for videos over 31 seconds long, you have to be getting more than 50% watch time. If you're not hitting those watch time metrics, well then guess what? You're not gonna get pushed on the For You page. There's gonna be no chance of you going viral. The majority of viral videos that I have seen in the past 3 weeks have been 11 to 13 seconds long. I'm not saying that all of your posts should be 11 to 13 seconds long. I'm just saying that the majority of viral videos that I've seen in the past couple weeks have been that long. So I would strongly suggest recreating the trends that are that short. Why? They get a high amount of watch time, they get good engagement, people follow you after them, and TikTok knows that they have an audience for this content. In fact, if you've watched my videos before, you've heard me talk about it a ton. TikTok is gonna be releasing 3-minute videos. The reason that they've been holding off on that is because they're seeing that shorter videos are actually doing way better, and no other platform has been able to replicate that. Instagram hasn't been able to, YouTube Shorts is coming out, they haven't been able to replicate it either. TikTok is able to destroy in that really short space, so I think they're gonna continue down that path, so we might see a pause on 3-minute videos coming in the future. That being said, if you guys want 2 viral TikTok ideas, the first one, Hold Your Breath Challenge. It goes viral all the time. I strongly suggest you guys find the Hold Your Breath Challenge, duet a video that has gone viral on it, or recreate your own, but trust me, duetting one that has already gone viral, great way to gain a ton of followers really quick, and just to get a post that really, really does well. In addition to that, doing things like Simon Says or creating a game out of your content, like what emoji did I have in the beginning of the video, that increases the watch time significantly. These are little things that you guys can add into your content, no matter what your niche is, that will get people in the comment section, get people looping the video, and get people really, really, really increasing your watch time by watching the video over and over again. That's one of the secrets to blowing up on TikTok, and that is what the best content on TikTok does without you realizing that it's doing it. That being said, for those of you that are really struggling to get a high amount of watch time on your content or creating content that TikTok wants to push out to people, I strongly suggest you get into my mentorship program where I guarantee that I can help you grow on TikTok in the next 30 days. It's incredibly simple. You're gonna go through a course, then I'm gonna send you a personalized plan, tell you what to post, when to post, what hashtags to use, what kind of content to make, what kind of series you should be making on your account, and so much more. And then over the next 30 days, I'm gonna check in with you every 48 to 72 hours to guarantee that you grow on TikTok. The way that it works is you either grow on TikTok or you get your money back. No questions asked. I'm telling you guys, TikTok is the biggest opportunity on social media. You do not want to miss out on it. If you're watching this video right now, odds are you have been missing out on it. So please make sure you get into this. I'm so sorry about that text message popping up, but please guys, you guys really need to take this seriously. I missed out on Vine. I missed out on Facebook. I missed out on Instagram. I did not miss out on TikTok, and I don't want you to either. Shoppable posts are coming to TikTok. More businesses than ever before are trying to pay influencers to post on TikTok. I'm telling you guys, you need to get your following right now because this organic reach is not going to last forever, and you guys need to get it now so you can make money later, because there's a lot more money coming to TikTok. The same exact thing that happened to Instagram when they got shoppable posts, and it came out that Instagram influencers were a huge way to make money. So please guys, grow your following right now while there's organic reach. If you want to learn more about the mentorship program, go to the link in the description. If not, I strongly suggest you guys check out the videos I'm about to put up on the screen, because they are the videos that YouTube thinks you should watch next.